pretty much every Alfa Romeo is much more than a simple means of transportation, but some Alfas are more special than others. Over half a million Giulia saloons were made, so this white Giulia may not look like much to the casual observer. Yet we are in the presence of automobile royalty here, as the Giulia Ti Super is among the rarest and most collectible post-war Alfa Romeo models. Presented on the 24th of April 1963 on the Monza circuit, the Giulia Ti Super was Alfa Romeo's new weapon of choice for touring car racing. Only 500 cars were made between 1963 and 1964, all painted in Biancospino white except for two examples, one finished in red and the other in grey, to satisfy special requests. The Ti Super was, to all intents and purposes, a homologation special. Considerably lighter and more powerful than the regular Giulia Ti saloon presented just a year prior. The Giulia Ti Super is about 100 kilos lighter than a contemporary Giulia Ti, largely thanks to a simplified interior and exterior specification. For example, the inner pair of headlights are replaced by a mesh grille, while the bumpers lost their overriders. Ultralight magnesium wheels were standard equipment, but this example currently wears modern aluminum replicas of the original design, for safety reasons, given the magnesium wheels were prone to corrode destructively following even the slightest of damage. However, the originals have been preserved. The green clover leaf badges on the fenders and on the boot lid were standard too, while the stripes on the bonnet are a nod to the cars raced in period by the Jolly Club. The interior, which has been completely restored to original spec, has these two lovely lightweight bucket seats instead of the bench commonly used on early Giulias, and the door cards were simplified as well. One detail few people know about the Giulia Ti Super is that the bodies had a serial number stamped on the upper edge of the boot, something unique to this model and not present on regular Giulias. As always with Alfa Romeos, the best bit hides under the bonnet. The Giulia Ti Super's 1.6 liters all-aluminum twin-cam 4-cylinder engine was rated at 112 horsepower at 6,500 rpm, an over 20% increase over the standard Giulia, thanks in no small part to this gorgeous pair of Weber 45 DCOA double-choke carburetors. However, it's fair to assume the engine in this car may well have a few more ponies still, given it's been fully rebuilt by the late Samuele Baggioli, who used to prepare these cars for racing back in the 60s. It's been fully balanced, has higher compression pistons and reprofiled cams, and sure sounds as well as it looks. As it's been certified by Alfa Romeo's Heritage Division, the production date of this example is in September of 1964, which means this car may well be one of the last Ti Supers made. Shipped to Buenos Aires shortly after manufacture, it's unclear how and when this example found its way back to Italy, where it resurfaced in 2009 in the warehouse of a large company that traded timber. Following the firm's bankruptcy, the Giulia sat unused in a depot until the beginning of 2018. Thankfully, it's since fallen into the best hands imaginable, and now it's good as new. The Ti Super's racing career started in 1963, competing in the Grand Touring class, given the model wasn't homologated in the lower Touring class until January the following year. Although it achieved some notable results in hill climbs and rallies, The Giulia Ti Super largely failed to live up to the marque's expectations on the European touring car racing scene. Tired of playing second fiddle to the Lotus Cortina, the Alfa Romeo engineers developed a lighter and more focused model, launched in 1965 as the Giulia GTA. But that's a story for another time. This video has been made possible thanks to the legendary Scuderia Del Portello. I'm very thankful for the time they've dedicated to me and for letting me bring you this unique Giulia, which is currently for sale. The contact details are on the screen right now and in this video's description. And if you've made it this far into the video, you'll undoubtedly enjoy one of the two other videos appearing on your screen right now. See you next week, and please don't forget to subscribe to Roadster Life.